time window compaction strategy. Mem tables have a write time. So whenever we have data in memory, we track the write time of that mem table. Don't remember if this is the lowest write time in the set or the highest write time in the set, but it's one of them. But we track, it's a property of the entire mem table, which depends on the data that you currently have in the mem table, right? But there is a number that is the write time of this mem table that is a summary, as I said, or min or max of the entire data set that you have in that mem table. When you write that to storage, the SS table will inherit this property. The idea of time window compaction strategy is that the way you combine those SS tables is by combining data that were written at more or less the same time. And this is pretty interesting because there are a lot of use cases in which people use Scylla that are time dependent in some way, right? So maybe overwrites are only possible within a time window, or even more common, like I have data that is TTL'd. The holy grail of time window compaction strategy is to allow you to drop an SS table. Because usually the other compaction strategies, if all of your data is expired, let's say all of your data, just imagine that you have a 25 zettabyte table and all of it's expired. It's all TTL, all gone. You don't really know this, right? So what you have to do is you're going to read every key. And then if it's expired, you drop it. And if it's not expired, you write it back to the new SS table. So if you have like this gigantic amount of data and it's all expired, in the other compaction strategies, you're going to have to read a lot. And then hopefully, you're not going to write a lot into the new SS table because a lot of that is expired. The holy grail of time window compaction strategies, because you know that because all of the keys in this SS table were written at the same time window, and if you have a TTL, I can actually drop the table without even reading it, drop the SS table in this case. In the worst case, drop the entire table, but in our example, I can drop the entire SS table without reading anything, because I look at the, I can see that the 100% of the data is expired from the metadata. I can see that everything was written in a particular time window, and I can know that I'm past this time window, so I drop that. If you are able to do this, time window is the strategy for you. If you have to ask qualification questions in that, but what about if I come, like, then it's not for you. Because then the opposite happens. If I have now, I'll explain how it works, but if you have a single key that is now preventing this entire SS table from being expired, now you're in trouble because you're never going to touch that SS table again after its time window is gone. So time window compaction strategy, it's really great for cases in which you can just delete the entire file because you know everything is gone. Or in cases in which, for instance, you are append only or things like that, and you know that your data comes in, like you have sensors or et cetera, and then you know that at most I'm going to look at one file. Let's say the time is part of your partition key. So, I mean, if it's a different, or even better, the time is part of your clustering key. So I know, like, okay, it's not this time. I don't have to touch this SS table. So those are cases in which it's good for. So how do you use time window compaction strategy? I'm showing how to use, unlike the other compaction strategy, because that brings all the important properties to light. You're usually gonna say, what is my window size? What is the unit of my window size? So I'll say, for instance, 4 days. So everything that happened in the span of 4 days gets compacted together. How? Size to your compaction strategy. So I keep accumulating, during those 4 days, I'll be doing size tier compaction strategy in that window. You keep adding data. I'm not going to just leave it accumulating. I'll be doing size tier. There is no difference between size tier and time window for the current window. So in the current window, I am just doing size tier. When a window gets old, it ceases to be the current window, I do one final major compaction, which is to compact everything into a single SS table. So even if I have 32, doesn't matter. I compact all of them into a single SS table, and now I never touch this window again. So now you understand, like when I said, if you have this one key that was not TTL or whatever, or was inserted, now it belongs in a time window that is old. You're never getting rid of that again. Because it's in the whole point of time window compaction strategy is not to look into that time window that is old. So it's going to be there forever. And that's where we started getting the questions like, oh, I inserted 1 gigabyte of data and I have 4 petabytes of data being used. So yeah, because in each one of your SS tables, you have one key that is preventing everything to be deleted. And I'm not going to touch it because that's the whole point of time window compaction strategy. So good patterns for it is that, again, as I said, when all of the data is inserted in the same window, right? So data that belongs together goes together. One good example is that, for instance, if I have a partition key being the user, the clustering key is the timestamp in seconds equal to the insertion time, and I have a query like this. Because even in this case, that's the example in which I'm not TTLing anything. Like, but I know that when I query for time window. We can also discard the SS tables based on clustering key as well, right? So I look at that SS table. I don't even, just at the metadata, I don't even need to look at the Bloom filters. I know, oh, I'm querying for a time window, right? But if you come up with a query, like if I decide to do a query, like let's say in this example, the time window is 1 day. I have 1 year of data and the time is the clustering key. And I decide to do a full scan on that year, I'm going to read from 365 SS tables. And if you call me a liar, because if it's a leap year, it's 366, I'm not going to talk to you again. Just let's keep things simple. But 365 or 366 SS tables. Again, bad pattern. You will be better off reading from a single SS table. So in that case, I mean, if I do this query once a year, fine. But you know, just if this becomes a query that is part of your workload, that's going to be pretty bad on the terms of read amplification. You're going to have a single query that needs 365 SS tables to serve. Not great. 10 minutes. That's our last time window.